we have a head set up here with numerous blend shapes in Maya. Animating these various blend shapes allows us to actually make the character talk. Add Voice-O-Matic in the equation, and setting up this head to create automatic lip syncing based on audio files becomes extremely simple. By default, inside of your Maya folder, if Voice-O-Matic is installed, you will find the Voice-O-Matic folder. If you then go under Scenes and open Sample Scenes, you will find a few sample audio files. So, I'll open one of the sample audio files here, activate it, and set the length. Once this is done, the audio file is now active inside of Maya. And we've done that directly from Voice-O-Matic. The next step is to actually map the various preset mouth positions. And by default, we have a series of 9 preset mouth positions. So we want to map the various blend shapes to these poses. If we open the Voice-O-Matic outliner, we want to select one of the shapes, and by clicking the Get Curve button, it is automatically mapped. And then, for each of the visemes, we will repeat this operation. You actually only need to do this operation once, and that is the beauty of working with Voice-O-Matic. Many people will repeat the operation whenever they want to reanimate their character. But what you can do is save that setup by saving a Voice-O-Matic mapping file by clicking the Save Mapping File button. Doing so saves this particular setup as a mapping file. So I will save this as woman.vom. For demonstration's sake, let's quickly close and reopen Voice-O-Matic. How this works in Voice-O-Matic is that no data is saved besides the animation that is created in your Maya scene. So when you reopen Voice-O-Matic, the audio file you had selected is not present anymore within the plugin. But what you can see here is that since the audio file we had initially loaded in Maya is still in the scene, we now have a new blue button called Use Current Wave File. So by clicking that button, as its name suggests, Maya's current audio file is used to generate the keyframes of the animation. In the viseme mapping section, you will notice that all of the visemes and mapping I had previously done are lost. So as I have mentioned, you do not have to remap every single parameter. By clicking Load and selecting the mapping file we have created beforehand, your settings will be restored. Once this is done, simply click Process Lip Sync, and once that is done, you can hit Create Keys and take a look at the resulting animation. So using Voice-O-Matic, we've been able to easily create lip sync animation in our scene. In this specific case, we've been using a blend shape setup. Uniquely with Voice-O-Matic, we have the ability to save the mapping and reload it on our characters, resulting in an enormous time saving, since we only needed to do the mapping once. Thank you for watching this quick overview on the use of Voice-O-Matic's mapping file in Voice-O-Matic Maya Edition. Voice-O-Matic is a unique tool available for Maya, Softimage, and 3ds Max that allows you to automatically create lip sync animations in any language with any character trait. Feel free to download the trial version of Voice-O-Matic at www.di-o-matic.com.